In this video, I am going to solve one of the toughest problem of a JEE advanced. So we have given that fx is equal to limit n tends to infinity n power n x plus n by 2 up to x plus n by n factorial x square plus n square x square plus n square by 4 up to x square plus n square by n square whole power x by n and x greater than 0. And we have to choose the correct options from the 4 options given. So we have fx is equal to limit n tends to infinity n power n, and if we take n common then x plus n will become 1 plus x by n, and here if we take n by 2 common then we get 1 plus 2x by n, and here if we take n by n common then we get 1 plus nx by n by n factorial, and here if we take n square common then we get 1 plus x square by n square, and here if we take n square by 4 common then we get 1 plus 4x square by n square, and here if we take n square by n square common then we get 1 plus n square x square by n square whole power x by n. And we get fx is equal to limit n tends to infinity n power n, and n times will become n power n, and 1 plus x by n, 1 plus 2x by n up to 1 plus nx by n by n by 1 into 2 up to n will become n factorial, and we have already 1 n factorial, and n square n times will become n power 2n, and 1 plus x square by n square, 1 plus 4x square by n square up to 1 plus n square x square by n square, and 1 into 4 into up to n square will become n factorial square whole power x by n. Here 1 into 4 into up to n square is equal to 1 into 4 is 2 square up to n square. It is 1 into 2 into up to n square, and 1 into 2 into up to n is n factorial square. So we get fx is equal to limit n tends to infinity and n power n into n power n will become n power 2n, 1 plus x by n, 1 plus 2x by n up to 1 plus nx by n factorial square by n factorial into n factorial will become n factorial square and n power 2n, 1 plus x square by n square, 1 plus 4x square by n square up to 1 plus n square x square by n square whole power x by n. And n factorial square and n factorial square will get cancelled, and n power 2n also get cancelled, and we get fx is equal to limit n tends to infinity 1 plus x by n 1 plus 2x by n up to 1 plus nx by n by 1 plus x square by n square into 1 plus 4x square is 2x whole square by n square up to 1 plus n square x square is nx whole square by n square whole power x by n. And if we take natural log both side, then we get ln fx is equal to limit n tends to infinity, and this x by n will come here, times ln 1 plus x by n 1 plus 2x by n up to 1 plus nx by n by 1 plus x square by n square 1 plus 2x square by n square up to 1 plus nx square by n square. And it is ln fx is equal to limit n tends to infinity, and we have limit in n, so this x will come out of the limit and 1 by n, and this will become summation r is equal to 1 to n ln 1 plus 1x by n 1 plus 2x by n up to 1 plus nx by n will become 1 plus rx by n, because r is changing from 1 to n, minus ln 1 plus x square by n square 1 plus 2x square by n square up to 1 plus nx square by n square will become 1 plus rx square by n square, because r is changing from 1 to n. And if we take r by n as y, then ln fx is equal to x times, if we use limit as some concept here, then this whole will become integration from 0 to 1 ln 1 plus r by n is y x minus ln 1 plus r square by n square will become y square and x square dy. And if you don't know limit as some concept, then limit n tends to infinity 1 by n and summation r is equal to sum phi n to r is equal to psi n f r by n is equal to integration from a to b fx dx, where a is equal to limit n tends to infinity and this phi n by n, and b is equal to limit n tends to infinity and psi n by n, and r by n is replaced with x. So here n tends to infinity, so 1 by n will be 0 and n by n will be 1, and we have already x present, so we replaced r by n with y, and now if we take xy as t, then we have dy. So if we differentiate with respect to y, then we get x dy is equal to dt. So we get ln fx is equal to integration of y is changing from 0 to 1. So when y is equal to 0, then t will be 0, and when y is equal to 1, then t will be x, and ln 1 plus yx is equal to t minus ln 1 plus y square x square is equal to t square, and this x times dy will be dt. And we get ln fx is equal to integration from 0 to x ln 1 plus t dt minus integration from 0 to x ln 1 plus t square dt. And if we differentiate both side, then differentiation of ln fx will be f prime x by fx is equal to differentiation of this portion will be ln 1 plus x by 1 plus x square. And now option D is f prime 3 by f3 is greater than or equal to f prime 2 by f2. So f prime 3 by f3 will be ln 3 plus 1 is 4 and 3 square is 9 plus 1 is 10, or it is 2 by 5. And f prime 2 by f2 is equal to ln 2 plus 1 is 3 and 2 square is 4 plus 1 is 5. It is 3 by 5. So we can clearly say that f prime 2 by f2 is greater than f prime 3 by f3. So option D is wrong. Now option C, f prime 2 is less than equal to 0. So f prime 2 by f2 is equal to ln 3 by 5. We have f prime 2 by f2 is equal to ln 3 by 5. And ln 3 by 5 will be less than 0. And we have x greater than 0, so fx will be always positive. So f2 is positive. So we get f prime 2 is less than 0. So option C, f prime 2 is less than equal to 0 is correct. And now we have option A and option B. So we have f prime x by fx is equal to ln 1 plus x by 1 plus x square. We have f prime x by fx is equal to ln 1 plus x by 1 plus x square. And fx is always positive. It is always positive. So if x belongs to 0 to 1, if x belongs to 0 to 1, then 1 plus x will be greater than 1 plus x squared. This implies 1 plus x by 1 plus x square is greater than 1, and this implies ln 1 plus x by 1 plus x square is positive. So if x belongs to 0 to 1, then f prime x is greater than 0, and if x belongs to 1 to infinity, then 1 plus x will be less than 1 plus x square. This implies 1 plus x by 1 plus x square is less than 1, and this implies ln 1 plus x by 1 plus x square is negative. So when x belongs to 1 to infinity, then f prime x will be negative. So when x belongs to 0 to 1, then fx is increasing, and when x belongs to 1 to infinity, then fx is decreasing. So this is 1, and before 1 fx is increasing, and after 1 it is decreasing. So f1 by 2 is greater than equal to f1 is wrong, and f1 by 3 is less than equal to f2 by 3 is correct. So the correct options are B and C.